New headphones. These motherfuckers are annoying to have, actually, because the earbuds are designed to look like Yoda, and they have the pointed ears. So you're putting something with fake pointed ears, plastic pointed ears, into your earlobe. If you don't do it correctly, it's gonna stab your motherfucking shit. It's gonna hurt like a mofo, and it's kinda heavy, so if you're leaning a certain way and it doesn't fit quite right, it's gonna fall off. But it looks cool when you can see it. But I wanted to say that we should keep politics political. That sounds utterly pointless and redundant, but when you think about political matters and the way we're over-politicizing everything, it matters a lot, my message, because we'll make just about anything into a political matter or a political issue. Case in point, school shootings. Whether it's Elliot Rodgers or Adam Lanza, there's always some new name, some guy that's attempting to high score or attempting to imitate those zero-day niggas, Dylan and Eric. That's the first time I said Dylan and Eric. Sometimes I'll say Dylan and Cole, like those twins from The Suite Life of Zack and Cody. Maybe I got Yoplait Yogurt and Danimals on my mind. Knowing me, that's probably in the realms of possibility. But the problem with the fact that we're making that into a political issue, case in point, Twitter's hashtag YesAllWomen, an eponymous, powerful message that's out there to prove that all women are threatened by males, or they feel threatened by males. And of course it makes no sense, but they're trying to dig themselves deep to find something out of this case. Always trying to find something. What about Trayvon Martin and George Zimmerman? Really? What the hell does that have to do with anything? A neighborhood watch guy gets attacked by a teen and he shoots him down. Yes, he was attacked by him. Look at those scratches on his face. Look at those marks. And yes, he probably shouldn't have followed him around, but they fucked up when they tried to make him have a homicide charge. They probably could have charged him with anything else, and you could find something that worked. But as usual, people don't know the law. And it's not really a political issue, whether you're talking about guns or the race issue, that people are targeting black guys more often, especially black youth. And going even deeper past the 24-hour news cycle problem, we have the conspirators and their whinings about things like Benghazi or any of the CIA coups, anything of that nature. The fact that prisoners in Guantanamo Bay or Guantanamo, I don't know. Yeah, I'm bad with the M's and N's. But the fact that they're being force-fed because they want to eat because they were protesting or because of religious practices, whatever. Or the fact that, yes, some innocent people probably are still around that area, being held in prison indefinitely. And when you put it all together, you realize none of these things matter in a political sense. In the sense that it has nothing to do with how a governing body manages its people, how it manages the outside world. It really doesn't. Small little atrocities or things we'll incorrectly label atrocities make no difference to the political body or political structure of a designated place or area. It doesn't really matter. You see, if the United States' practice of enhanced interrogation tactics, semantically labeled as that, but it's really torture, if that ends, if justice is served for George Zimmerman, if all these school shootings would stop, if, what else, besides school shootings, if there was justice for people in Benghazi, if there was justice for people that were killed and American citizens killed in drone strikes, like that Arab guy that was dead, then really we'd still have all the same problems. Nothing would really change. Nothing would improve. Nothing would worsen either. I'm not saying that the opposite would be the case, just that these individual tragedies or things labeled as tragedies to tell a story and to sell a story, they don't really mean much. They have no impact on the political day-to-day operations of any place, of any governing body. To put it simply, it doesn't matter. Things that do matter. The connection between race and crime. The fact that whites aren't reproducing as much, that in America they've shifted into being the largest minority group. Economic issues, of course. Our level of debt, and not just the debt, but the fact that we are not moving as an economic body. These things matter. They're not the only things that matter, of course. But, no cultural decline. The fact that it may be over for the age of antibiotics because we're using them so much, because we're engaging in promiscuous activities, because we're not taking care of ourselves as well due to our luxuries. So we're going to abuse those luxuries and we're going to lose them relatively soon. That's a big problem. The fact that things that we had vaccines for, diseases that we could take care of easily, that's not going to be very efficient anymore. See, those are things that matter. Gay marriage, not that important. Gay adoption, the loss of the family, the fact that single moms are abused more than moms with a marital spouse, that their boyfriends beat them more. These are things that matter because having non-biological members of the family at a large rate is going to lead to more damaged kids. Decline in television shows. People are no longer sure of what to pursue in their future because they have unrealistic dreams, expectations, they're living vicariously through other people. They want to be LeBron James. These things are problems. And Benghazi is not a problem. See, the fact that males are getting lower in testosterone, the fact that they're less healthy, because of that, we're getting more diseases. See, trans people are more susceptible to heart problems. We're getting issues related to our diet. This lipid diet, while I'm not a paleotard, I prefer us just sticking to a high-fat diet. It's going to really affect the way we live our lives because we're more depressed now. Because we're moving less, eating more, feeling more thoughts of suicide, and we have like an athlete's diet where most of us aren't even athletes. What the hell is up with that? So yeah, these things on a high carb, low fat diet, unless you're lifting weights, just like a diet with too much proteins. Too much proteins have the same problem as too much carbs or too much sugars. Yeah, those will bite you in the ass. So that's all I gotta say. Towards the end of this video, it did become a long-winded rant, but I like that because it's 2011-esque. Anyways, this is Mr. Wonka 7. Suck my dick.